We have the student. We have the students of Princess Umayyah University of Technology. Today we are talking about slang vending machine. This is a project for embedded system class. This project is done by Wasim Arafa, Ahmed Abu Jazar, Munzir Wahbe, Saif Sharif. Outline. Me, I will talk about the introduction. Saif will talk about the main component, electrical design. Munzir Wahbe will talk about mechanical design, project picture, flowchart. Finally, Wasim will talk about main difficulties and conclusion. Introduction. The main goal of this project is to create an embedded system, snack vending machine to provide the user a snack by entering his or her university ID number followed by password given from the administrator. We will do this project by using PIC16F877A and using MicroC we are learned in the embedded class.
I'm going to explain the main component of our project. First component that we used is the PIC16F877A, which is the prime component of our project. The next component that we use is the three servo motors, the 360 degree. We use breadboard, voltage regulator, potentiometer, LCD, keypad, and two buttons, 9 volt and 6 volt. First, we connect the PIC16F877A on the breadboard and connect the three servo motor on port D to take the PWM signal, which is port D1, D2, D3. The servo motor is connected to the voltage source of 6 volt. We connect the LCD at port B and we connect the keypad at port we connect the keypad at port C. The potentiometer that we use in our project is to control the resolution of the LCD screen. The voltage source of 9 volt, we use a regulator to add to give the microcontroller that we use a 5 volt constant voltage.
Now we want to talk about the mechanical design. We have in the mechanical design, three servo motors are connected to 3 metal springs, as you see now. These three servo motors are pulse width modulation from the back that we calculated before. So they move as we want to. The thing in the spring will move forward until they get down and take it from our vending machine. Now we will give you a picture for whole project after we end and make it the box. This is the spring. Before it there is a three servos motor. This is a keypad and this is an LCD. So we will tell you what is the value of the keypad and LCD now in our software. This is a flowchart of all our software. At the start, we put a username, which the ID of the students, and then it's check. If it's no, they come back, and if it's yes, they go to another step, which is input our password. Then when he input his password, they check. If this password is not connected to the same username, they go again and ask about the username. If it's yes, they go to the database of that username and ID and tell him about his budget. Then it's ask him to select what kind he wants from our vending machine. After that, he can select motor 1, motor 2, motor 3. There is three different kinds. Then after that, it subtract from his budget and go again to the username.
Hello, every group of students face some problems during the process of their project. Our first problem was the springs, as we see, that are connected to the servo motors need a special blacksmith to do it. A special device, actually, because each metal should have an accurate space between them for the pick to provide it a pulse width modulation to move the item forward. So our first blacksmith who did for us the track, as we see the metal track that the servo motors land on, couldn't do the springs. So he was telling us to go to other friends he has around. But after days of searching and asking people around us, we luckily found one far away around 10 kilometers from the university. Our second problem was that the lab provided us all the tools to work on, like the pick and the LCD, keypad, everything we needed for the project. And everything worked perfectly, but when we went and bought our own stuff from a special place and redesigned our project in a special breadboard, we faced a problem that the LCD was viewing weird words on it. So we ignored that the problem from the LCD because it was viewing for us a different words, and we thought that the problem was from the programming on the micro and other parts. So after days of replacing parts and trying different work, the problem was from the LCD. Conclusions: the combination of hardware and software implementation was learned in embedded system class. We had more knowledge of PIC 16F877A interfacing was cleared by going through the project. A nice experience was gained through using MicroC software. This project developed in us the sense of how to deal with problems faced during the process. Finally, the result of group working improved the strength of our work. Thank you.